They're here. After about a month of waiting from when I ordered them, these are my new loupes, and I'm super excited to finally get these, unbox them, and give them a shot, which also is a perfect segue into what I want to talk about in this video, which are three tips that will help you pick a pair of loupes that you will absolutely love. I'm excited to try these out today. Sim clinic, practicing for CDCA. Hopefully I can get used to them. I know that choosing loupes can often be intimidating, and for some reason it's one of the first things that you do in dental school. I understand that they want you practicing in sim clinic with loupes, but you also don't know anything about how to choose loupes, what to look for, those kinds of things. If you are looking for things you should consider when choosing loupes, there are great videos out there. One of them being Stephen P. Ray. He's got a great video on this. Go ahead and check out that video, but don't forget to come back and watch this video. Hopefully, by implementing the three tips I'm going to give you, you can save yourself a couple thousand dollars and avoid buying a second pair of loupes before you even graduate dental school. Like I did. The first piece of advice that I want to give is do not feel stuck with whatever company your school might have a contract with. I'm not sure how common this is, but when I started dental school, our school had a contract with Orascoptics. I've been happy with my Orascoptic loupes overall, but had I had the option to go with another loupes company, I might have done so. There was a $500 part of our tuition and fees that covered a basic pair of loupes, and you could upgrade the light, magnification, those kinds of things. But no matter what, everyone was paying at least $500 for a basic pair of loupes. If your school has a contract, don't feel like you absolutely have to go with that company. View that money as a sunk cost, meaning it's already gone. And I know that that can be hard to swallow, thinking, oh, $500 just down the toilet. But in the long run, if that allows you to get a pair of loupes that you love, you'll be saving yourself money long term. I get it. Maybe you don't want to spend the time reaching out to a few different companies to see if they can come out to your school and demo their loupes and measure and fit you. But if you take the time to do this, you can find a pair of loupes that you absolutely love. A few of the big companies are Orascoptics, Q Optics, Designs for Vision, and Lumident. There are lots of others out there, but those ones are well known and will be linked below to get you one step closer to being in touch with these companies so that you can find loupes that you love. And if it just so happens that the company your school has a contract with seems great, then by all means, spend the money and upgrade the loupes and choose the specifications that you actually want. My next tip for finding loupes that you absolutely love is to choose loupes with adjustable magnification. Now, before you go down into comments and say, this is a terrible idea, they're heavier, they're more expensive, and you won't even end up changing the magnification. I know, and that's the point. By choosing the loupes that have the adjustable magnification, it's like you get multiple pairs of loupes to demo, and you can find out which magnification is right for you. Some people love minimal magnification, like 2.5 times. Others want more, like 3.5 or 4.5 times. The loupes that I just opened are actually 5 times, but they're actually more similar to a 3.5 times zoom, which is what my first pair of loupes was. And I know this is starting to get technical, but magnification is such a personal preference. You can ask a bunch of people and they might all tell you something slightly different. Being able to determine for yourself what magnification you want is the ideal situation that fixed magnification loupes just can't give you in the beginning. Future me here. I didn't realize this as I filmed, edited, and basically got everything done for this video. until today, which is the day before it's supposed to be posted, that Oroscoptics is the only one that has the adjustable magnification loupes. I just assumed that all of the loupes companies had that as an option, but it's just Oroscoptics. So if for whatever reason you just have no interest in the Oroscoptic loupes, I would suggest going with a higher magnification versus a lower magnification. And then my third and final tip still holds true. It seems like a lot of students who go with around a 2.5 magnification end up going with a higher magnification as their second pair of loupes. Sorry for that, and back to the video. And this brings me to my last point. All of the companies that are linked down below have a 45-day trial period. It's very common for these companies to give you a trial period so you can get used to the loupes, try them out, and if necessary, you can make any changes that you determine are necessary, including changing magnification. So remember when I suggested getting the adjustable magnification, once you decide what magnification you like, you utilize this trial period, send the loupes back, and get the fixed magnification of whatever your preference is, so that way they are less expensive and lighter, which will be better for your neck and shoulders. And seriously, if you don't like anything about your loupes, the frames, the light, the magnification, any of that, do not be afraid to send them back. You are investing a good chunk of money, and these will serve you day in and day out for many, many years if you choose the right pair of loupes. Take the time and go through this process so that you can end up with a pair of loupes that you absolutely love. And hopefully, you won't have to buy that second pair of loupes, like a lot of dental students end up doing right before they graduate. Ugh, I don't think I could have said the word love more times unless I was absolutely trying to.